All right, we're back broadcasting live at the Toms River Auto Group Studio right here in Northfield. Billy Schweim, Nikki Earnshaw. 609-403-0973 is the text board. We're giving away autographed baseball by Tommy Green. And he was down there signing autographs at Blitz's Markets a couple weeks ago, and a card that he signs is nice for your man room. And, of course, we got in the second hour, we're giving away an Eagles souvenir football provided by Pro Image Sports and Fan Treasures. 609-403-0973. The question is, you got to text in to 609-403-0973. Who are the next players to be inducted into the Hall of the Eagles or Phillies Hall of Fame, respectively? 609-403-0973. Right, Nick?
Yes, perfect. Okay. Eagles Hall of Fame as well as the Phillies Wall of Fame. Who should be next?
Now it's time for On the Mound with former Phillies pitcher Tommy Green, sponsored by Blitz's Market in Ocean City, located at 21st and Asbury Avenue. Try their famous breakfast sandwiches, hoagies, gourmet burgers, vegetarian options. They have them as well. Online ordering is available at blitzesmarkets.com or give them a call at 609-399-9983. Start your day off with Blitz's freshly squeezed orange juice. Mention the locker room and get a dollar off their 12 ounces of liquid sunshine. Let's go to the Toms River Volkswagen Sports Hotline and welcome into the locker room our good friend. He pitched a no-hitter, former Phillies pitcher Tommy Green. Good morning, Tita Green.
Good morning, Billy. How you doing? It's been a few weeks, pal.
Yeah, I know. And I want to apologize for last week. I just was caught up in so much stuff going on. I forgot you were on vacation. But I literally called Scott Eyre, like, after we hung up with you. He said, oh, no, I forgot. We called Scott Eyre. He was on his way up to the Darren Dalton Foundation golf thing or whatever you guys had for Darren last week. And he came out of the bullpen for you, and he saved us.
Yeah, we're good. That's what his job is.
Now, I know, Tommy, you're going to say to me, Billy, I told you so. 2 weeks ago, I was pushing the panic button. But I'm glad I did, Tommy. It woke people up.
Well, your panicking is not waking people up. Yeah, I texted you and told you.
I know you did. I read it to everybody on the radio program. I read your text. Tommy's already telling me, I told you, chill out.
Well, I mean, Billy, that's baseball. It's sports in general, you know.
Right.
You go through your good times. You go through your bad times. You're just hoping your bad times doesn't last as long as your good times.
Yeah. Yeah, but Tommy in Philadelphia, fans are like, we're sitting on edge. We saw the Eagles collapse last year. We saw the Sixers collapse. We saw the Flyers, even though our expectations weren't high for the Flyers, they still had an opportunity to make the playoffs, and they lost their last seven games. So people, it was justified my panic.
Well, you can see that, but you have choices in life, Billy. You can choose to be more on the positive side, or you can be a negative Nelly like you.
Negadelphia, we got a new segment called Mr. Negadelphia. When something could go wrong, it probably will. But Tommy, I'm glad you got me down off the ledge. Let me ask you. I want to ask you this question. I actually know what you're going to say, but I want to hear you say it. And I said something to Nick Earnshaw in the beginning of the show. So the Phillies went through a tough stretch. They hadn't won a series at home since July 9th, 11th against the Dodgers. Then they had that collapse. They start really playing bad. Everybody's slumping. They come back and they get healthy against the Marlins and the Nationals. Is that good enough for you? Does that convince you that this team's on the right track, beating up on these two lesser teams?
Anytime you start winning ball games and doing things the positive way, you know, is a good thing. No matter who you playing, but it's a good thing. They got to make hay against teams they need to make hay against. You know what I mean? And they need to do that because they still got, you know, coming up. They got some tough schedule coming up, and they got to be playing good ball. You want to be playing good ball going in. You know, especially the first, you know, September when you're in playing consistent ball. You don't want everybody to be down on that slide again, going down the wrong way. You want everybody trending in the right direction. And that's, you know, and right now that seems to be which way it's going. You know, I play one game at a time. You know that, Billy. I don't look too far ahead. But, you know, it's just, you know, you got to keep working and doing what you do and what you do well. And there's some guys that are really, even though they've struggled a little bit during this course of this since, you know, in July in the All-Star break and to, you know, up until recently, you know, there's some guys that are still trending in the right direction. You know, I'm looking at Castellanos and you look at him since July, you know, what he's done. You know, he's basically hit 300, you know,
Yeah, he's up to his batting average right now. Collectively, he's up to .249, which was like he was at the Mendoza line early in the season.
Yeah. So I mean, he's changed his approach a little bit about things. You know, he's using all fields. You know, he's a swinger. You know, that's what he does. You know, but his approach and the way he's approaching it mentally is a lot better. You can see it in what he's doing. Thing, he's making more contacts. He's not. To me, don't look like everything's trying to jump yard all the time. You know what I mean? Trying to hit it over the fence right. all the time. Even though that's what the fans want to see, you know, and all that. If you put a good swing on it and the ball's in the good zone, you're swinging at decent pitchage, you're going to run into some balls that you elevate. You know, to me, like Stott is one of those guys that, you know, compared to last year to this year, he seems like his swing seems to be more trying to more lofty, trying to hit it out of the I don't say trying to hit it out of ballpark, but it looks more that aggressive uppercut more so than he had last year, that approach. You know, he still tries to give you quality at bats and works deeper in counts, but, you know, the base hits and stuff the opposite way and stuff are not coming, you know. I mean, but the pitchers have adjusted to him a little bit, and they're trying to pound him and make him turn on balls, you know. But he still can't try to lift and turn. You still got to turn on to hit them hard, you know what I mean. You still got to make that contact.
Yeah, Tommy, it was reported earlier this week that the Phillies had a team meeting, players-only meeting. Rob Thompson really wouldn't delve too much into it. What are those type of meetings like when you're struggling and trying to get back on track?
Well, I mean, it's not that we had a bunch of them. You know, it's just, I'm trying to remember if we ever had a player.
Well, you had the Macho Row. I mean, there was like a handful of guys that you just didn't want to mess with.
Well, we just had a lot of one-on-one, you know, especially stuff, when I come up, you know. But there was times like Lee Thomas wasn't afraid to come down from his perch in the general manager's office and come down and lay the law down, you know. And, I mean, I've seen a couple good snaps by him. Coming down, you know, when we were playing like crap, you know. I mean, it's not that everybody was playing like crap. Just in general, we weren't playing good ball as a team and finding ways to lose rather than finding ways to win, you know. And he was just letting us know he wasn't going to put up with it too much longer, you know, that type thing. But does that change things? I mean, it's not like we're going out there to fail. We're still working on going about our business. We're, you know, trying to be professionals. You know, that's right. What we are. That's how we got to where we're at, is being consistent and stuff. So you're trying to work on things that put you in a positive way and lets you go out there and free up to play. And that's the thing, you know, when you start going through bad stretches, a lot of it gets mental, you know.
Right.
I think a little bit, you know, it's good to see Turner turning around a little bit now. He's starting to, in the positive five. I think he gets a little mental at times, you know, and he goes through those long stretches. But, you know, he's still hitting .300 now above. You know, he dropped real fast, you know, because he went like oh forever, right. You know. But yeah, I mean, that's the nature of the beast. It's the game's got a strange way of humbling you out when you think you got it licked a little bit or you're going good. It just kind of, you got to take the ebbs and flows with it. Don't let the waves get too big, you know, and try to, and keep working on the things that you know that make you do things well.
Every Sunday throughout the baseball season, we go on the mound with former Phillies pitcher Tommy Green. Tommy, what do you think's harder, hitting for the cycle or throwing a no-hitter, which you did in 1991?
Crap. I mean, that's a good question, dude. You know, well, in my case, you know, hitting for the cycle would probably be because me legging out a triple. Yeah. There had to be a strange bounce like Weston got that the other night. I mean, he got that big bounce like that, which helped. That was the huge one, him to be able to get
first
a triple
one.
Like that.
Hey, Nicky, let's ask.
He had good backspin on that single.
Yeah.
Back up, it spun back from the second baseman. Yeah.
So you got to be lucky for to hit the cycle. You got to be good, but you got to be lucky to pitch a no hitter like you did in 1991. You got to be. I mean, come on, Tommy. That's right, Tommy. So we're asking a question. We're giving away one of your autographed baseballs that you when you came down the blitzes. You signed. We already gave one away. It was a great. We had a lot of people texting in for that. 609-403-0973 is the number. But Tommy, let me ask you, who do you think the next person should be inducted into the Phillies Hall of Fame?
Well, I mean, it's a good question. They got some guys to choose from, you know, with I don't know what they're looking at for as length of time, you know, since retirement or something like that. But you got, you know, obviously the guys that mean a lot to Philadelphia, you know, is Jimmy and Chase and Ryan, you know, that group of guys, you know, you're looking, you know, it could be, I'm obviously one of those guys. I mean, at some point they're going to be, but, you know, so that's the way I look at that stuff. You know, I mean, you have the alumni weekend, you know, and every year do the Wall of Fame. Do you necessarily need to put somebody on the Wall of Fame every year? No, you know.
Right.
I know this past weekend, yesterday was that Wall of Fame and enshrinement was well deserved and needed to be there, probably before now. You know,
yeah,
I mean, because it should the year he passed, that next year he should have been, you know, shouldn't have been up. If you ask me, I mean, he was one of the reasons the Phillies are who they are. You know, so.
Tommy, what did you make of yesterday's ceremony? And you know they had the angle out in the outfield and center field. Monty's angle. What did you make of that honor for David Montgomery?
Well, that's pretty cool. You know, Monty's angle because I mean it's different, and I think it's good. You know, along with things like that. I mean, because he was obviously one of the big deals to make that, you know, Citizens Bank happen. You know, and a part of that having this ballpark, you know, that people love and have enjoyed since it opened in 03. So, I mean, having him up on the wall like that so everybody can see every time they come in and sit in the stands, that's what it should be. You know, I like that part of it, you know. And it couldn't be a more of a great honor for David Montgomery because, you know, the type of man he was unbelievable. I've never seen nobody like him. As far as you meet him at the ballpark, you know, as far as all the employees and stuff like that, it seems like if he met you once and you told him your family's and stuff name, he'd come, and next time you met him, he'd ask about him by name. That's he was one of the best people about that. He remembered everybody and make sure he's like, he made it personal.
He included everybody.
Once, twice or 100 times, you know.
Yeah.
So.
Hey, Tommy, today we got Taijuan Walker going for the Phillies. He's got 11 games. He's 3-4 with a 5.68 ERA. Talk to us a little bit about what you see in Taijuan Walker, and will he? I mean, coming down the stretch, can he turn it around? Because he really hasn't had that. I mean, he's had injuries, and what do you expect from him today?
Well, I mean, I just wanted to see him go out and give it his best effort. You know, like he sort of did that last time. You know, I mean, he had that he give up what, two runs in the first or something like that, and then give up a solo homer, and that was it. And he ended up pitching what, five innings. I mean, he kept us in the ball game. But your ERA doesn't reflect on how you pitch. You know,
right?
So I mean, we got to have that fourth and fifth spot have got to wake up and give us consistent starts. Now, I mean, is it going to happen every time? No. Everybody's going to kind of think, but we went through, you know, here towards the end of the season, if we want to keep where we're at, we got to, you know, you got to mix in some consistent starts and keep us in ball games and give us a chance to win, you know, 4-3, you know, 5-4, something like that, you know, because our offense is waking up. You know, you look at the line for the past week, you know, we're leading. I mean, the whole lineup, I think, is, you know, we're hitting over 300 for the week for the past 7 days.
Yeah.
So, as far as in baseball, that's pretty good, you know. So we're doing some positive things, not necessarily hitting home runs. I think we hit four home runs this week, which is like, I can't remember what it was, like 25th in the league or something like that. So we're finding other ways to score runs, which is a good thing. You know, it was nothing better for me last night, or was it last night, when they got down a bunt. You know?
Yeah. Yep.
That everybody was safe. You know, yeah. I mean, and it was a sacrifice, and it was just a well executed bunt.
Yeah.
You know,
small ball, the little things.
They're doing the little things. Yeah. You know?
So. Tommy, I want to thank you so much for getting me down off the ledge.
Oh, I got to rely on the other guys. To make sure, you know, I mean, they treat your rope burns. You got
Tommy, I
got to.
Tommy, I got to reel him in. Trust me, I got to reel him in too.
Tommy, we love hearing from you each and every Sunday. Have a great rest of your day. Tell Wendy we said hello, and let's go Phillies.
I sure will.
All right.
All right, man, you got it.
There he is, right. Tommy Green on the Tom's River Volkswagen Sports Hotline On the Mound with former Phillies pitcher Tommy Green is sponsored by Blitz's Market in Ocean City, located at 21st and Asbury Avenue. Try their famous breakfast sandwiches, hoagies, gourmet burgers, and vegetarian options. Online ordering is available at blitzesmarkets.com or give them a call at 609-399-9983. Start your day off with Blitz's freshly squeezed orange juice. Mention the Locker Room and get a dollar off their 12 ounces of liquid sunshine. That's Blitz's Markets. When you get in there, say hello to Joan and Dave and Teresa and Kenzie and Maggie. The whole crew's down there. They do a great job. All right. The first hour of the Locker Room is powered by Surety Title. Surety provides comprehensive title insurance protection and professional settlement services for home buyers and sellers, real estate agents, brokers, lenders, home builders, developers, and attorneys to facilitate your real estate purchases. From the shore to Center City and every place in between, Surety Title is there for you with 15 office locations in New Jersey and PA. That's Surety Title. For more information, call my good friend Ron Conklin at 856-988-8900 or call the Ocean City office at 609-399-1227. Now, just about everybody in our area has heard about the Jersey Man and Philly Man magazine that is run by ex-Philadelphia tight end Ken Dunnick. But were you aware of the private business network they call the Legacy Club? Every month, they hold private events at upscale locations in Philadelphia and South Jersey that attract over 200 top business people. If you have an interest in attending one of these events and see if it's a fit for your business, send an email to ken@jerseymanmagazine.com or give them a call at 856-912-4007 for more information. I got to tell you, I go to several of these Jersey Man events. It's getting bigger, the ball's rolling, and there's so many business people there that you make great connections and it could be great for your business. Give them a shot. All right, when we return, we'll wrap up the first hour. You're listening to The Locker Room with Billy Schweim and Nikki Earnshaw right here on 97.3 ESPN.